start grinding out even more. But you'll see some interesting strategies throughout the run that I've started to pick up. Alright, so here's a tight jump here. Got it. Wiimote D-pad isn't the greatest. You'll probably see me have a few D-pad shenanigans here and there. There is a strat where you could jump off the Waddle Dee, and I just did not do it. Here's a big gimmick. And we'll see this ability again, I think, two more times. But it's, kind of slow. Most things don't slow you down, but getting hit by the rockets do. Alright, I'm gonna try my best to avoid them. Yeah, there you go. Yep. That's the Wiimote. I'm gonna jump off of those as soon as possible. Take the bottom row. In 100% you go top route because you have to get an extra piece of furniture. Ability. Once again, really just introducing it to us. Use it there. So every time you suck up three enemies, or three objects, and you get this ability, which you have to use right here. Gonna see this guy a bit more. He's gonna keep asking to come see his brothers, but kind of ignore them. Some of the better music in the game. I mean, is it better music? Some of the best music in the game. And here, I think I might. I should air stall there. You'll see some air stalls. Basically, if you throw an item while jumping, it'll stall you in the air for a bit. There's a few levels I use it in. Very niche kind of use. And you can't actually speed up there. For some reason, it just, like, instantly slows you down. Yeah, you'll notice the spinner actually takes a different amount of time. It all depends on how it interacts with the pegs. Which is, again, partially RNG. I mean, it depends on when you actually hit it, which is super hard to control. There's a tough strat that involves you grabbing one of the arrows, and arrows are basically just like a one-hit KO. But it involves some interesting jumps. Thank you. That level's really fun, but the advanced strats are very difficult. Yeah, there we go. He wants to introduce us to his brothers. We don't listen. A lot of cutscenes. It's about 50 seconds of cutscenes at the end of each level. For bosses, it's a bit more. You'll see why. Now there is a fast strat here, I will try to go for it. It is kind of tight, because of how the items, because of how the yarn balls despawn. There's no harm in going for it. Timing is kind of tight there. It was about 15 seconds, I think. So it's about 15 to 20 seconds if you miss that. Not a big deal. Yeah, so here are the cutscenes. Doing that, opening the map saves, I would say about a second. Puts you at a better spot as well. Alright, Hotlands for me is the, hardest world. So I'm gonna focus a bit more on this one. Here we have pretty much another auto-scroller. You can get hit, and lose a bit of time. But that's pretty much just an auto-scroller. Yeah, Yeah, that was pretty good. Happy with this run so far. I'll probably stay a bit quiet during some of these animations, just so you guys can admire the beauty of this game. Yeah, definitely a very underrated game, underrepresented in the speedrun community. Gets a lot of garbage for not being like a traditional Kirby game, but it has the same charm. So this is not actually an auto-spoiler, because once you hit a certain point, the lava basically teleports to that, to a point right below you. So you do want to get there as fast as possible. Hopefully it doesn't get in the red. That's just as bad. Yeah, so it nudged the little pin and caused it to push back. That time loss, that like one and a half second time loss could add up very quickly. Yeah, I guess I should mention the person that got me into running Kirby, and it's also his birthday. Happy birthday, Rocks. He was the guy that got me into running Kirby. Didn't really have any Kirby games in mind, but I saw him doing it. I saw him not doing this game, but just doing Kirby in general, and I was like, hey, this is one of my favorite games. Might as well try to run a Kirby game, and I thoroughly enjoyed it. Yeah. think I was gonna make the cycle, but... That's not fair. This is one of the parts where 2P would actually save time. You can make some of the jumps a bit easier. But, kinda sucks that I didn't get to do 2P. Show off some interesting game mechanics. And you'll see me trying to undo the ground pound right before I touch the ground. Obviously, ground pounding, you go faster. You fall faster, but the landing animation is very long. About his brothers. Man, I don't want to see your brothers. You know, if there's time afterwards, I'll probably finish this ahead of schedule. We will check on his brothers. We'll check on his brothers afterwards. How about that? Here's one of my least favorite levels to play, but one of my favorite design levels, like... You can see the creativity in this level. There is a strat, you could actually swim faster than this, but it requires some insane mashing. And I personally am able to do around single button on a Wiimote, probably around 15 per second, but you have to maintain it for a long time. And it's just not viable, RTA. Like, not only does it require some crazy good mashing, but it requires some crazy good endurance. Yeah, here's the other shot. If you fall off, I mean, it's a lot slower, but... I tried, I fell off, and then tried mashing it. It is crazy difficult. Whew, I broke a sweat from that. Unfortunate. I didn't get it. It's gonna be some, nasty time loss, but... what am I gonna do about it? Like almost 50 seconds. I tried mashing it. It's super tough. Wonder if there's like a good hand position where you could kind of like just keep your finger on it lightly, but it's tough. All right, I'm just gonna say now, this is my least favorite fight. It's not fun. It's very slow. There is a fast strat, but it's pretty annoying. Not as annoying as the first boss, but it's bad. And if you have 2P, you could actually grab 2. You wait for another cycle and you grab 2 of them. Alright. Doing that to get rid of some of my beads. Beads do actually lose time after each level. It's not a lot, but you know, if you can, finish a level with as little beads as possible. Normally he does another attack here. Oh, you could do that. Save a bit of time. That's about 15 seconds over the normal strat. Really good. Apologies if you hear any like background wind, that's my computer blowing up from this. It's not a fan of me both streaming and local recording. With 3 tabs open. I did not mean to move there, but you know. Here's the cute Kirby you wanted. I You're basically intended to ride just one of these guys. You can kind of just skip through. Hit me. Wow. Alright, this is the one time we use the pointer. You gotta draw train tracks. And I try not to let him fall because, you know, if he falls, he actually goes really slow in the air. Should be able to grab that. For a second, I thought stream died. I have it open in the background. Just so I know it's recording smoothly, but... Alright, I was actually practicing this run a lot earlier. This level is very confusing. That was pretty good. Actually, coming back from that 50-second time loss in Fire 4. Thank you. pudding skip anyone? Not sure why, in a game where you really can't die, they put this pretty difficult platforming section. Like, that is a tough section when playing casually. Breaking a sweat just doing this. Alright, this is my favorite level. It's music themed. I am a music guy. Kirby is just vibing. That's a great level. It's also a great way to learn movement. So if you're like just starting out and you want to learn this game, great level to start with. I mean, other than obviously the first one with the tutorial, but that one's a bit more complicated. It's got moving stuff. Thank you. Alright, I'm gonna do two card, not three card. Basically, he does, he has a card attack. So if you don't hit this, he actually does the card attack second, but if you hit him on this one, then he does it third. I'm actually going to hit him on this one. It loses a bit of time, but it's way more consistent. So for two cards, we stand right here. Look up. Grab it. He'll come right over here. That simple. Believe it or not, I didn't learn about that strat until I have like a 159. And it saves over a minute. It's crazy time save. Alright, now we have Mashing Simulator. Water. Every single water level. Not much else. I mean, there's some cool gimmicks. This one has a really nice theme to it. But it's water levels. Rip. I missed it. Wasn't fast enough. I guess I should say now that we're in the lower part of the game. Huge thanks to the guys at Really Really Longathon for having me on here. I know it's not the longest run or it's not the most lore heavy run. Though, don't even get me started with Kirby lore. It's a fantastic run that's rarely done at any small marathon. I don't think it's ever been done at GDQ, or ESA, so none of the big marathons, but it hasn't really been run at any small marathons either. So it's great to finally have one, finally have a run of it. Once again, it's just mashing. Swimming in this button, or swimming in this game, it's just pressing two. Yeah, I mean, this game is definitely more interesting in terms of lore than other Kirby games. Or, not more interesting, different. I don't want to get into the whole Kirby lore discussion. It is crazy what they could put into a pink blob. I just enjoy the games. So the whole gimmick of this level is you're going behind. You know, I just realized there's plenty of levels with this theme. I don't know why they didn't just make a world around it. Like, definitely one of the cooler. What am I doing? Whoops. Not sure if we hear that music again. The music in this game is just incredible. Guys, we're almost done with water. It's a very short world. It's not even 10 minutes long. Maybe it's about 10 minutes long. Probably the shortest world in the game. If I had to give that title to one of them. Now this is the only time you hear this music. D-pad for you. Alright, now we got the boss fight. It's a short boss. About as long as the previous one. So there's actually a little strat you could do right here. I didn't learn about this until recently, but... Oh no, I didn't hold the button! Oh, that's very annoying. Very bad. makes the fight like 30 or 40 seconds longer. Water's over. Now we go to snow. Frozen water. Hey, what was that? That sounded like something popped or cracked. Okay. Maybe a bit. I have to lower my voice a bit if my family's starting to go to sleep. So, don't want it too loud now.
Thank you.
That was really good spin RNG. Basically instantly stopped. Alright, this is an auto-scroller. It's the only full auto-scroller in the game, to my knowledge. This level's really fun. It's very fast moving. If I am smart with how to navigate. Thank you. Alright, we're gonna fight a familiar boss. Very familiar boss. Next, we're gonna fight another very familiar boss. And, you know, we're in the snow world, I think you can guess who it is. Here he is, the man himself, or the penguin himself. I was almost good. We're on a pretty unique world. Don't really see much like this in Kirby games. Very futuristic world. That's not completely destroyed. Looking at you, Forgotten Land. Yeah. getting trolled. Doesn't actually save any time, it just looks fun. Ah! I think it's base 4 that's that, like, has some of the coolest movement in the game.
Quack 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 qu
Not sure if I could still get a PB, but we'll try. Okay, this level. This level has some really good movement. So if I could do it right, it's a great example of how cool this game is. Oh, I got it. Let's go. You basically skip having to go all the way around. Very good. Very cool. Come on, don't hit. Oh no, that's the slowest spinner I've gotten. You'll see why. No shot, I just got top planet. Okay. Okay, dude. Okay, dude, that's like 15 seconds. That's crazy. Oh my god. I'm insane. Yeah, you just sit at the top and hold the button. Actually, you're supposed to mash the button. That's why you want to hold up and mash one. Yeah, it was 12 second gold. Top planet is crazy. It's not fun. The music's good though. Got some really good music. Go! Yeah, you see, it's RNG. He literally just needs to come down and hit me. Or, I guess I could do that. I don't realize I could. Well, good to know that now. Wow. I don't think I've ever seen this bad of RNG. This is awful. What, dude? Oh my god. The D-pad. Oh my dude. It's over. It's over. I lost the run to RNG. I gotta love it. I guess it can't be a really, really long thon, or some formation of it without a run being lost to RNG, right? This is just, this is crazy. What? 50 bad dude. I am crying. I just lost like 3 minutes.
Oh my god.
I'm impressed at that RNG. That was so bad. Alright, now we're in Dreamland. Not really any RNG left, which is a good thing. Or at least nothing that, like, determines the run. Hey, at least it's still sub-2 pace, which is all that matters. I was almost on 4x pace until that, by the way. I think it was like low 51 pace. Unfortunate. Right. I mean, if I can gold the rest of these, I will be happy. I'll be happy with this run. Alright, two more levels, and then we have the final boss. Now this time flew by. I actually prepared that. I have a notepad on my screen with that joke. Oh, I'm so glad I was able to use it. Thank you. There is a fast strat with this boss. I guess with the boss at the end of it. Basically, if you just get really close to him, you'll have all three of the projectiles hit the boss, and it does like triple damage. Basically, just gonna shred this boss. Alright, one more level, and this is... This level's really fun, actually. Also, the animation for it is really nice. Not Kirby game without some version of the gourmet race. Alright, final boss time. Probably gonna be around 155. Just not bad by any means. Especially since my PB going into this, was... My PB actually submitting was still like a like a 206, 207. Yeah, I think it might have been a 203. I don't know, it was definitely not sub 2. It's very tight. Is it a boss? No. Not over yet. Whoever, I don't know who's doing the timer, but yeah, it's not over yet. That I think the timer on there is like 30 seconds ahead on the stream. I have my own timer going. I'll let you guys know because I made a mistake starting it. Timing ends as soon as you go through the thing at the end. So like the unwrapping thing. Alright, there we go. At 155.06. Here, I'll just like yoink. There we go. There it is. I'm super glad I got to run this. I did say I would show you guys the brothers. We've been getting annoyed the entire game. We gotta meet his brothers. I finished ahead of time. So let's do that. Yeah, I think no one's on the time. It's okay. Alright, here are his brothers. Furniture and fabric shop. Look. Oh wait, I want that. Oh, DDD. We gotta get Meta Knight now. Man, no Meta Knight. I'll give it one more. And then I'm gonna have to, then I'll have to send it off. Aw, no Meta Knight. Not even an enemy. Wow. Okay. Well, yeah. I don't know where I bring it to. Alright, I guess actually before I go, I guess some shoutouts. You guys could find me on Benny the Doc, that's my Twitter. You guys can find me there. You could find me on twitch.tv/BennyTheGreatYT. I'll just type in chat. There we go. You know, that kind of stuff. Shoutouts to everyone running this event. I'm so glad I got to run. Hopefully I'll get to do another one in the future. Maybe actually do a long run. Still gotta learn 100% for this game, so maybe once I do that. But yeah, thank you so much for having me, and I'll see you guys soon. And yeah, thanks for tuning in.